Okay, hopefully this will work better than last time. Last time the kilobytes kept going out, so may have to switch cameras. We'll see. Anyway, so welcome to Cooking with Jason. We are doing the whole chicken today. Turn this around and see it there. I do my chickens a little differently so they cook a little faster. So the first thing we gotta do is we gotta cut off the tail and throw that out. Whole chickens always come with tails. I always just cut them off and throw them out. I think some people make a stew out of the, make a soup or something out of the pot, out of the extra parts. I don't do that. I'm not that talented. I am. I just don't want to. I'm lazy. And I cut off a little bit of the skin to kind of get everything going. I make incisions. Here, down the middle, and I do this to kind of speed up the process. Otherwise, this would take forever. Whole chickens are not easy, they're stubborn, but you wanted it, so you're gonna get it. Also gotta clean out your bird before you cook it sometimes. So I basically do a pre-carving. That's kind of what this is. Just because it takes a lot less time to pre-carve the damn thing. You want to get a very sharp knife to cut through the chicken bones. This will take about an hour and a half to 2 hours. It will not take a long time. It will take a long time. So this is not something you just throw in and make like we normally do. This is a meal. This will last about a couple of days, even with my eating habits. No way I can eat a whole goddamn chicken in one fucking roll. Sorry, you see my butt there. But yeah. So that's all the incisions I make. So then we wash our hands. I set the oven to 400 degrees. That's kind of the temperature I like for a lot of things. It just cooks faster and better. I watch my things profusely. So we spice it with a little of Italian seasonings. Little bit of lemon pepper. And a little bit of garlic powder to kind of make things go really well. A lot of the sides we're gonna be nuking, so I'll show you what I'm making, but a lot of it just gonna be nuke brew because I'm kind of tired. I have a lot of work to do for school, for the classes I'm taking, for the online, so I don't have much time today. I barely had time to do this. I'm gonna put a little bit of marination, sauce there, a little bit of marination sauce there. This is the same sauce we've been using for our meal for the pork chops. This is made through, if you want to know where we got this sauce, check out the egg video. I linked it below the pork chop video. If you can't find those, I will link them below this video. So don't worry. Our pan here is a little small for our legs, so we're going to try to cut those off, actually. So we got to get our knife back out here. And unfortunately, we got to cut the legs off. Sorry, Bertie. We will cook this in the same pan. We just got to do some work here. If you can't get a good cut, try to cut into the skin and then cut the other direction. This is kind of a bad knife. So I'm gonna have to cut a little bit like that. Plus, chicken bones are extremely difficult sometimes. That's why you don't give them to dogs. That and they crack easy in their mouths. Alright, so. Get a little tricky here. Bust out the thigh bone. I have a lot of arm strength for this. Luckily, we have arm strength. Feel like a manly strong man when you do this. I'm kidding, it's a bad joke. It's a really bad joke. I'm not being serious. Okay. So and we do this. Do that. Incision the skin here. Make it apart right there. We try to find the bones. We try to break them or cut them. Cut the meat around it and then cut into it if you can. I realize you can't see this. Never mind. That's what we're doing. I apologize if you couldn't see it. I was trying to get a good angle to see what I was doing and I ended up blocking it, so my apologies. But right now we're doing horrible, unspeakable things to a chicken and we're trying to. That's a bad joke again. I'm not funny. Don't mind me. Okay. Hey, Crystal. Sorry for blocking the view there. All right. We're almost. We're having meat issues. Chickens are very, very stubborn, unfortunately. They're stubborn animals and they're stubborn things to cook. Okay, we're almost done. We're almost done. Okay. And voila. Okay. There. That's how you do that. And you want to rip, you want to do a mixture of cutting and ripping the legs. So just kind of like that. And I'll. So, mixture of cutting and ripping the legs off to to kind of get everything out if you're using a small glass pan like this. Then you get your aluminum foil and you put it over like that. Now what I do with chicken, and this is kind of the different parts of it will cook at different speeds, and that's why it's so goddamn difficult to make these things, is I will set it on intervals of like 45 minutes. So I'm gonna put this in there for on the closest pan for 45 minutes. And I'll check it. That doesn't mean it'll be done, but that does mean that we'll have to probably do it again and again and again and again. Make sure both the thighs and the white meat, the breasts, are both fully cooked. The dark meat takes so goddamn long to cook on chicken. The next, we're gonna make broccoli potato fries. This is nukeable, so we're gonna cheat. I think it's nukeable. There's not nukeable. Okay, it's not nukeable. I gotta make these. These are not nukeable. So those I gotta make separately. This is cauliflower rice. This is nukeable. So this is 5.5 to 6 minutes. I'll put it on timer. There it goes. Forgot how that worked for a minute. I'm sorry, my brain is all over the place today. Okay, so then we put our vegetables in a pot, in a pan. We'll have to put these in a rack. These will go in later. We'll probably put them in now. And we'll probably just check off time for getting done fast or slower. So I don't usually make more than one thing in an oven. However, I'm a little pressed for time, so I'll make more than one thing in the oven today, and we'll just wing it. You have to learn how to adapt when you cook, otherwise you'll never survive. At least not with decent meals. All right, gotta get this out of there. Veggies are in there. I always use cold water to defrost them because it has less bacteria than hot water. And then I reheat it like that. I make sure I cover all my food so that it cooks faster. I'm gonna get baking sheet. I don't got a baking sheet. I'll use a pizza sheet. It's the same goddamn thing. improvising works. All right. So separate those like that. And throw that in there. And we're pretty much done after that. All we have to do is just check on shit and let it cook. Remember to make sure your meat is fully cooked and whatnot. Sorry, I blocked half that bird. I didn't realize it. I can do a turkey if you want. That is a lot of waiting though. I don't really want to do it. So I will post in the stream, I think tomorrow or possibly Wednesday. I'll show you all how to make pork shoulder. That'll be really good. I usually make it in a bit of a stew. You'll all like it. So it'll be pork shoulder stew with beans and vegetables and potatoes and whatnot. So that's this. I'll show pictures, kind of press for time, so I kind of cut some corners, but hey, it works. But that's all you do. Make sure everything's not pink, and make sure it's covered, and make sure it is, get fully cooked. This'll take, like I said, about a couple of hours, probably. I gotta do it in intervals, so by that I mean I have to check on it, do 45, check, cut into it, do 45, check, cut into it. It'll be a couple times. So, that's this. Be safe, everyone. Be smart. We'll all get through this, and I hope you are all going to be safe and whatnot. I will post pictures. Love you all. Bye. Thanks, Crystal, for your enthusiasm.